Hey, Bat Buddies, I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy1, and today, once again, I'm taking the time to show something I did a long time ago and kind of describe it and give a little bit of detail on it. This is what I did when I saw the second Dark Knight movie come out. And I said, you know, a lot of people are going to want to do these things, and they're going to want to put these all on a piece of fabric like Hollywood did. And I said, some of my Bat Buddies are just going to want to do something simple. They're going to want to have this latex hold together and have all the pieces there where they need to be. I want to offer it in a generic way. No bat, artistic interpretation of the shapes and the way it's put together. No texture behind here. I've seen people add texture. I've seen people paint this. Latex is very paintable. I've seen people take this apart and still put it on fabric. But, hey, I was inspired. Again, I didn't like the movies very much. I liked the first one better. But I've always been into Batman, and I said, I'm going to go ahead and put this piece together and sculpt it. This is all sculpted. There's no computer-aided 3D printing or anything here. This is all sculpted. Back in the old world, you know, way back then, and I just wanted to share it. So what some of my Bat Buddies have done is they put a foamy across there, made their own bat. I've considered making a bat, but I try to stay away from symbols and trademark things. I try to offer things as generic as possible to a few of my Bat Buddies, and so it's just what it is. I don't have the other parts. I don't want to have the other parts. I try to just offer a few generic, high-quality latex pieces and know that some of the things that I might offer my Bat Buddies are hard to come by, and then they can take it and do whatever they want to with it. They can add their own accoutrements or own whatever other parts and make some kind of a suit for themselves. This is not designed to be accurate. I did these great big kneecaps on here. The reason I did that is because I wanted people to be able to put their knees underneath there and not have to worry about placing something. These can always be cut off and you could put some other kind of kneecap. And I didn't do any further armor there or anything like that. And this isn't really exact up here or anything like that. It's just my idea of what a generic piece like this would look like. So I just wanted to share it with you. I'll do a couple of close-ups here. So all the pieces are just independent little sculptures on a form below so they all stay in place. This facade goes over an undersuit and everything will hold together. You'll put straps here and here and here going around the undersuit or use glue and mount it that way. A strap here and here around your arm, maybe a strap behind, Velcro, elastic, you name it. The straps go anywhere you want. I suggest multiple straps to connect in the back over an undersuit and go around and hold this facade over your undersuit for a seamless look. It doesn't go all the way around, it's not intended to. It's made for a photo opportunity. We're not gonna go out there and fight crime. I wouldn't even wanna inspire that. Even though this isn't authentic, like I say, this could be cut off and you could put a different type of kneecap on if you'd like, but it's there for you. Some people may find that this is too large for them. What they can do is they could cut it right here and cut it right here and bring this up together, take out a number of inches under the belt area and make it so that the knees fall where they need to. And with proper placing and tailoring like that, very simple tailoring, it'll work for a lot of different Bat Buddies. And it has. And this is just raw latex. I recommend a light coat of Plasti-Dip spray for a dark uniform protective finish. One of the things I really like about latex is that it's paintable. I've seen people put textures up here. I've seen people put textures in here and different colors. I've painted it myself. I take it even farther away when I paint it and more into the generic realm because I'm not trying to duplicate something. I'm trying to have a fun, fascinating Bat Buddy sharing world. And that's what I've done with this piece. So once again, I didn't know what the real thing looked like. I had never seen it up close. I just saw some impressions and I tried to sculpt them and create them artistically in a generic way, the way I thought they might ideally look. I gave enough definition to them coming off the suit so that in any light, it's gonna show how volumesque it is. It's gonna show the piece for the piece itself, wherever you are. They're not just plates put on there and glued over. Each piece, each area is volumesque and sculpted by itself as an intrinsic, this is a piece of artwork type of thing. An interpretive piece of artwork, all put together on one sculpture all at one time. That was what I was going for this, and I had fun with it. I've shared it with a few Bat Buddies over the years and they've had fun with it. Doesn't get a lot of calling, but it's there. And I never took the time to make any videos or talk about it really that much, so I'm doing that now. Thanks, Bat Buddies, for tuning in. I'm taking a little break from the regular things I do on this channel, and I'm taking the time to talk about some things I don't normally talk about. And so I thank you for being here, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. I'll talk to you later.